and welcome. In this video, we'll be discussing Momentum, a versatile planar electromagnetic simulator that accurately accounts for electromagnetic effects in your designs. We'll start by setting up a Momentum simulation. Next, we'll discuss some simulation options, such as frequency, RF versus microwave mode, meshing, far field analysis, and then finally a patch antenna analysis using Momentum. Momentum is one of the more versatile tools within Genesys. Not only can we evaluate a circuit such as this, a microwave filter, but also antenna structures, as well as physical structures which do not have closed form solutions. Here you see the layout for our microwave filter, and then a response. Response represents the linear simulation of our circuit. To perform a momentum simulation, we go to the workspace tree, analysis, and then add momentum analysis. And here we see the dialog for momentum, where we set up our parameters. We can change the name, the design layout. If we have more than one layout, we can point to different layouts. We can change the data set name if we want or accept the default. Description is just for adding notes to ourselves for future evaluation. The frequency range, in this case, we're going to mimic the linear frequency range, and that was 1.125 gig to 2.375 gigahertz. And you see here it's mimicked to the range that we did our linear simulation to. Okay, the next thing we want to do is set the type of sweep. We can select the number of points, as you see here. We can do a log points per decade. We can do a linear step size, like in this case it's 100 megahertz. Or we could do the adaptive frequency sweep, which is the most popular use of it. The number there, the 25, represents the maximum number of simulations Momentum will do before it attempts to plot a fast frequency or adaptive frequency sweep. Automatic recalculation, if you have tuned parts, you're changing physical dimensions, you would like it to do an automatic recalculate. One of the more useful features is the select and connect layout before simulating. That connects everything else, everything on the layout, if you're doing tuning of physical dimensions, and does that automatically for you. We can select units to be gigahertz, terahertz, megahertz, or whatever we wish. We can change the default impedance from 50 ohms to 100 ohms, or whatever works. In addition, you see this box for our use EM frequencies. It's checked right now. If we uncheck it, then what we can do is set a start and stop frequency and change the number of points. This is helpful if you're trying to generate data that exactly matches, let's say, a linear simulation where you may have 101 points and you want the number of frequency points, data points, to match up. And the reason you would do that is if you were trying to model some circuit to an EM simulation. So that's helpful for that. Under the options, the primary options are RF or microwave mode. The RF mode is primarily a static solver, and microwave mode, we need to use that when we do far field or antenna analysis, as well as when the circuit becomes an appreciable portion of a wavelength. The 3D metal expansion, if we have thick metal, up basically means that the metal is above the substrate, down it protrudes below or into the substrate. The VIA models, more generally, we just take the 2D model, but you have a selection there. The solve matrix, it's usually set to auto select, but if you're running out of memory, you might choose the iterative solver for that. The checkbox for use box basically puts a box around our circuit and allows us to have a metal box around it, and we can also have an open box at both ends, but basically that's what that means, is to use a box. The mesh, we usually allow that to use the analysis frequencies instead, or we can manually set a frequency for meshing. Mesh density defaults to 30 cells per wavelength, as well as the arc resolution. That's how the resolution or the arc of segments that are used for meshing up round circles and so forth. And the rest of these we primarily leave automatic. If you wish to know more about this or peruse that, I would welcome you to check out the help, so you can influence your learning or extend your learning. Far field options, you'll notice we get a dialog here that says we haven't done a microwave analysis. Of course we haven't and that's necessary in order to do a far field calculation. But we'll show you how we do this later for an antenna example. Now that we set up our momentum analysis, the next stage is to run it. So from the green arrow, we'll select Run, and in a few seconds, we're done. Okay, here you see the completed simulation. You notice that we now have gridding on our layout, and you'll also notice that the gridding is tighter towards the edges where the current density is higher. And this is automatically generated by momentum. What we'd like to do now is compare the circuit analysis to the momentum analysis. So I'll double-click to open and add more measurements. I'll change my data source to momentum data and then select S11, press OK, and that adds the S11 to our plot. Again, I'll do the same thing. Again, selecting momentum data set, S21, and now we have both the linear simulation and momentum for comparison. Because momentum accurately models non-adjacent coupling between resonators as well as other parasitic effects, we get much more accurate results than we do with the linear simulation. What I'd like to show you now is some of the versatility within momentum and how you can use it for antenna design. Here we have a plot, momentum simulation of this patch antenna. Here we can see the frequency response. And when I right-click on this, I can bring up the properties, and you can see how we set this up for an antenna simulation or far field. We're sweeping from 1.8 to 2 GHz. Under our simulation options, we've selected microwave, so we can, in fact, view the far field. And we've selected to calculate the far field, also to get the 3D information. We're collecting all the values for phi and theta. And we selected an EM frequency of 18883, which is close to our center frequency. You notice we specified a magnitude and phase for our voltage. This is not so important unless you're using two or three patches at one time, and you can change the phase and angle of each of those. If I then right-click, and down at the bottom you see a selection for 3D visualization. And here is the 3D visualizer, or a 3D viewing. And the first screen that you see here is the patch itself. We can view the various layers, both above and below our patch antenna. There's a substrate in the air above. And here we can set up which frequency that we want to view the currents and the antenna radiation pattern. Under the plot properties, we can set the transparency, we can add arrows to our plot, we can change the size of those, we can change it to log scale if we wish, we can even animate it so we can watch the currents real time on our patch antenna. We also have preset viewing positions, both isometric, top, down, side. We can dynamically change this if we wish, both for scale and zooming in. And then we also have a query, so we can look at currents at different parts of our patch. Oh, I might also add, we can also view the mesh if we wish to simultaneously. I've selected the far field, and we'll bring up the far field plot. And here you see this the plot. You can have the total E field that we're showing here, or theta, or phi, or cross field. We can do a log scale, we can do normalization or not normalization. Of course, you see the change in the plot as to whether it's log plotted versus log or linear. And we can change the transparency if we wish. And as you see here, I can rotate the plot manually, just like we did with the patch antenna. And then there are preset patterns or preset views that we can also use. And then we can view the antenna parameters, things like radiated power, efficiency, effective angle, directivity, gain, all of which are important in antenna analysis. So, what I hope I've showed you is how easy it is to use momentum and how effective tool it can be. Thank you.